Okay, review. And we're going to review something I got way back when with my Armada Ironhide I actually got. It's this. Transformers Cybertron. Was it Mega? I can't remember what it is. I believe it's Mega Class. Because they were Mega before Voyager, kids. Or was this when they moved to Voyager? Was it Voyager? Oh, yeah, sorry, it was Mega for Energon. I think it moved to Voyager for Cybertron, I think. Could be wrong. So, whatever it is, Nemesis Breaker. Oh, baby, oh, baby, oh, baby. Yes, it's a repaint of another figure, which is exactly the same, called Leo Breaker. But it's in the Nemesis Prime colours. And just, it looks pretty nice. I mean, look at that. This kind of turquoisey metallic colour, just, oh, that's nice. Nail head, and now don't get me wrong, as far as lines go, this is quite questionable. And the robot mode's kinda questionable. But it's also quite neat, so you have to bear with me. And I did get it for a particular reason, which I'll show at the end. And so, you've got this weird. Should I go into the series? Basically, you got a good guy called Leo Breaker, and then eventually, towards the end of the series, Megatron became Galvatron, I think, for some reason. I don't know why. And then just went, oh, by the way, I'm just going to make an evil clone of him out of nowhere. Bear in mind, I can't snap my fingers. And poof! Nemesis Breaker just appeared out of nowhere. He just made him out of thin air. It was like, oh. If you could copy anyone and make an evil version of him, sure you should have copied Prime. But whatever, fine, who cares? And so you got this guy, and legs are a bit, they go forward, they go out a little bit, but literally like that much. Bend, a little bit of toe, tail doesn't do anything. Shoulders are quite nice, they do the full, well, they would do the full 360. They go out there, they go forward, they rotate. Plenty of joints here. There's one there, one there. Plenty of joints. So you can go. Ooh, that's spoilers. So you can go. Ha ha! I'm going to scratch at you with my claws. Look how scary I am. But you may have noticed the giant things on the front there. That's to do with the planet key. And before I do that, I've just got to mention one other thing. Because if you see that little nubbin there, that little metallic nubbin there, you can press that. Its mouth opens ever so gently, but I mean, let's try and press it properly. Thank you for paying attention, Doc. Thank you. Bit stupid, but why not? But, Cyberplanet Key! And there's a slot in this side, and a slot in that side. And for argument's sake, we'll do it this side, just so you guys can see. So you put it in there. If I can find the thing, there you go. And fold out claws to make it even more scratchier and stabbier. Whoocha. Yeah, it's a bit dumb, but why not? Frankly, why not? There are worse gimmicks in the Cybertron line, let's be fair. I'll keep hold of that for later. So that's about it for the line mode. Let's transform it. And it's quite straightforward. So first of all, we're going to pull the tail off. It just plugs in there. Put that off. Fold down these nice giant heel sections on the backs of the legs. And then stand it up. So now we've got this middle section, and this is a little bit fiddly. You gotta try and get these side bits out and pull them down. Pull it down. And this will all come loose. Fold this back section down. And now from this, you wanna get it so that this that lump there goes into that hole there. We're gonna splay the arms out to give us clearance. I'm going to double hinge over the top and into place. Marvellous. Which point we rotate the arms out. Now, if you hadn't noticed this giant silver pin here, that's actually a thumb. Now you move the hands and have little thumbs. It's quite neat. Rotate the thumb, little hands. Yay! And then we kind of reach in and get this bit here from that big obvious gap. No, not split the body apart. Come on, behave. Flick that up. Push until it goes up as high as you can. Then you pull it out and pull with it the head. Ah, for some reason dirty. There it is. And head's not bad. Bit weird. Not bad. And this is Nemesis Breaker in robot mode. He's alright. He's all thighs, not much, you know, shin and little feetsies. Big gorilla-ish arms, but fine. He's just kind of funny. You know, you can take the whip. Sorry, the tail. Ooh, it also makes a whip. And there are little holes in the hands there, can you see? A little hole there. And you can peg it in there. You can have a whip weapon. That's fine, I guess. But you can also still use the key. Come on. Find it, there you go, to activate the claws. And because I'm funny like that, I also like to use something that's for the later modes, and you can actually, without undoing the waist, you can actually detach the arms. They just plug in. I like to be able to detach it and fire it off rocket punch, because, you know, what's the point of having a giant robot if you can't have a rocket punch, I ask you? I mean, really. Only problem with firing off your arms is getting them back. Anyone seen like the Great Mazinga cartoon and stuff like that? They end up having to run up and pick them up and stick them back on before firing them off again. It's quite funny. But yeah, he's trying to actually make him look like he's standing up straight. He's fine, you can still do the if you want. But yeah, arms go out to about there, they'll rotate all the way around. Fine. No waist swivel, but the legs will go out a bit. You can try and get some kind of dynamic posing out of him, but it ain't going to do much. But, yeah, no, it's kind of funny. Now, you see, if anyone knows anything about Cybertron being part of the Unicron trilogy, well, you might know those series had a bit of a thing for this whole combining stuff. Especially when it comes to Optimus. And although, well, the figure this is based on could combine with Optimus. It was really stupid. Like, if you've ever watched Gal Gigard, the big Goldion hammer, it's that kind of stupid. But because this is just a straight repaint, this can also connect to Prime. Apparently you can also connect to the Megatron from that series, but I never managed to get my hand on it, and because of the paint job, the Galvatron, because it's the same figure. But I never got hold of that Megatron, so I couldn't tell you. But it can connect to Prime. Should we do that? Let's do that. So I'm going to take the tail off. We're going to disconnect the arm. And we're going to fold up the toe, and we'll leave that out. We're just going to flatten out the hands and everything. And this peg sticking out here will actually go into a hole in the bottom of the foot. And it pegs in there. Okay. Now we're going to fold this heel up and this toe up. there is a reason why I'm doing this. I'll explain later. I'll just straighten that up and tidy it off. Shove the head back in. Pull this arm off. Straighten that up, tidy up. Straighten this out a bit. Again, plug hole. Peg hole, rather. Plug that in there. And this is one really complicated thing, because you can move this on there. I'm not sure why, but you can, to adjust it. But you can also slide this whole connection port from one side to the other. This bit I do sort of understand. So we're going to do this for what we're about to do. If I can talk properly. So what we're going to do is we're going to bring in Prime. And we'll bring this up a bit. Okay, you might notice one of Prime's arms is missing. And basically what you do is you just convert it like you would for the vehicle mode and just hide it in the back there. And there's space for two. We'll talk about that in a bit. So what you do is you get this big connector and you just plug it in there without detaching the waste again. That's loose. And just clip that over the top. Which now means that Prime has a really big, silly lion arm with this heel as a thumb, so to speak. I didn't say it'd be good, did I? What you can also do is these pegs are also the same size as the peg for Prime's little pistol. So you can give him a whip as well. Huzzah! So yeah, he's got a really silly lion arm. I did say that weight, I'm going to have to tighten that or something. It's getting really loose, I don't know why. And the weight's making the hinges and the waist. Stand up, Prime. I know you're getting old now, but come on, mate. I know they're trying to copy you with Siege and ruin you, but whatever. So, yeah. It's got a really big, silly lion arm. But it's kind of fun, and yes, you can still do both the claws and make it all big and clawed and scary and grr. Let's try and do that quickly. Feel the weight of this extra arm being on one side only. Completely, you know what? I've done this a few times since I've had this figure, because that's what I got the figure for. And it's never fought with me this much. Just because it's on camera, kids. Just because it's on camera. And look, now it's got a clawed lion arm. Isn't that scary? No, not really. So basically it's a really, really daft idea and really, really silly. And I kind of like it just because it's silly, frankly. But the point being, as there's another figure, exactly the same, but different colours, I kind of want to do both arms. I kind of want to. But it means tracking down the other one of these. And believe it or not, this one's easier to get. Don't know why, but it is. But that's something for another day. The point is, this is kind of funny. I wouldn't have it as a standalone figure, because it's a bit pointless. But if you've got Prime or Megatron, in fact, apparently it can, I'm sure he can connect. I'm sure I've seen pictures of it. Again, I've never had Megatron to do it. But if you've got Megatron or the Galvatron, because it's the same figure, I would recommend one of these, because they're funny. But, yeah, no. dear. But yeah, I've got a long week in work. I'm working every day, basically, and then the weekend I should have had free, I've now got plans for, which I didn't really plan ahead for. It was just kind of, by the way, this is happening. It's like, oh, Can't say no to that. Shame. But whatever. You guys are getting a review out of it. I'll try and do a couple more as the week goes on. So yeah. Transformers Cybertron Nemesis Breaker. Very, very stupid. Quite funny. So, I shall be ugly, I shall be wretched, and I shall see all of you in the next one. Later!